Today we are going to learn chapter 7, Political and Legal System in Natural Environment. So today we are going to learn about the government and how the rule of law is impacting the international business. I want to ask you, is it true or not? The political, especially the government, give effect to the international business activity. Yes or no? No, you can say no also. Can the legal environment, especially the rule of law and the system, can give any effect to the international business? Yes or no? For example, like the government can affect the international business, international business activities of a firm. For example, a government can stop export or the import of a firm, and the legal system can prohibit the activities by law. I give you an example. In Saudi Arabia, 15 years ago, maybe not 15, 7 to 8 years ago, they banned camera, camera featured phone. They banned the camera featured phone. And the government has stopped. That time very popular brand is not Apple, what brand? Nokia, yeah. Now Nokia is no more popular as before. So government has stopped Nokia from entering the Saudi Arabia. And the law of Saudi Arabia says ban the camera feature phone. So look like the government, through the politics, rule of law, through the legal system, affect international business activity of a firm. In this case, Nokia. So that's why we're going to learn today how the political and the legal system affects the international business activity of a firm. Realities of doing business in Russia. Realities of doing business in Russia. How many of you been to Russia? Never. Google. The world is in your fingertips. Yeah, it's in a hand. That means you can Google, touch where the country that you want to go and visit. Then you can learn many things about the country through Google, Googling. For example, high rate of piracy software in Russia. Is it true? But piracy is everywhere, even in Malaysia. But in Russia, the piracy is so severe. Bribery, so severe. SMEs may spend, for example, like 20% of their income to bribe. The bribe who? The government officials. Substantial organized crime and killings. People call mafia, isn't it? Or in other words, people call KGB in Russia. Is it true? Is it true? These are all the facts. Condition in Russia may be typical of many emerging market and developing economies. For example, Mexico. Also high crime. China. intellectual property law is very, very weak. Malaysia is a good example of emerging economy where we have a reasonable level of improvement in terms of bribe, in terms of intellectual property protections. We were very low, but we are getting better and better in terms of it. Even China is getting better and better. Even Russia is getting better and better. So what we are trying to show is, at one time, this could be in the past, not now. At one time, Mexico, Russia, facing this problem. But now they have improved in terms of the law and the government, in terms of handling those issues. At one time it could be, but now maybe not. So what is a country risk? What is a country risk? As I mentioned to you earlier, is also known as political risk. Country, the politics, government, all is in the country. Each country has unique political and legal system that often pose challenge for the company performance, as I mentioned to you earlier. For example, like Nokia. Another example is Coca-Cola, also facing a problem. Explain to you later. So, exposure to potential loss or adverse effect on a company operation because of some of the political and legal environment. Coca-Cola business fell in Germany. Why? Coca-Cola is a very popular brand all over the world, but in Germany, they have some problem. Because of political reason, the government of Germany has introduced some recycling program where they have to recycle all the can and the bottles. So some companies, some retailers such as supermarket feel that it is a burden for them to collect all the cans and the bottles. If they don't collect, and they are violating the government policies. So because of this, they do not want to sell the Coca-Cola at all. Because by selling Coca-Cola, they have to collect all the cans and the bottles. So because of this law by the government to say that please collect, the retailers and supermarkets don't want to sell any more the Coca-Cola. So it impacts the Coca-Cola business. As what it impacts the Nokia business in the Saudi Arabia. But over here is a recycling program in Germany. So you can see how the impact of a government law, government policies, government action can affect the business. Dimension of country risk. So we have many risks which we have learned in the chapter 4, cross-cultural risk. Chapter 4, we learn about it. Commercial risk, we will learn in the subsequent chapters. Currency risk, we also will learn in the future. Today, we are going to look into the country risk. And we have a lot of dimensions over here to look at. For example, can you see that or not? Over here. How full of unstable political system, how stable is the politics, law regulation in terms of handling the foreign firms, in terms of protecting the foreign firms. Inadequate or underdeveloped legal system. As I mentioned earlier, China was here in terms of protecting the intellectual property laws, maybe 5 to 7 years ago, very low. But now they are improving in terms of protection. So earlier they were inadequate or underdeveloped legal system, but now they are moving. But this is one of the dimensions that we are going to measure the country risk. Corruption rate, mismanagement of failure of the national economy. For example, like if you go to Venezuela, can you do business freely? If you go to North Korea, can you do business freely? So these are some of the things that impacts the business. So these are some of the dimensions we're going to look at it later. Where is Malaysia in this chart? This chart shows the country risk in the selected countries. Where is Malaysia here? This is high to low. You cannot find Malaysia, la. But Malaysia maybe is somewhere here, closer to Singapore and so on. Which country is the lowest over here? In this, this data was taken in 2007 by the Economist. 2009 over here. Sorry. Which country is the lowest? It's true, la. If you go to Singapore, you can see the government, the rule of law is a very conducive to do business. Very conducive. Conducive, huh? Very conducive to do business in Singapore. Next, Canada. Canada. Then we have Ireland, USA, and so on. Which country is the highest risk? Iraq. Why Iraq? Very high risk, huh? Zimbabwe. Iraq, a lot of political instability. Zimbabwe, also political instability, a lot of political unrest. Venezuela. What happened to Venezuela recently, huh? The President Chavez has passed away. Venezuela is another country where it's a socialist country. Socialist. So many people do not like country that implements a political system as socialist. So that's where many people doesn't want to go to Venezuela. They have confiscated some of the investment of, for example, Venezuela have confiscated or expropriate some of the properties of the investor. For example, like Total. Total is a fuel company where Venezuela, they invest in Venezuela. What happened? The country take the property. That's why many people doesn't like to go to Venezuela, Iran and so on. Like Russia, just I mentioned to you, a lot of bribery, a lot of crime and so on. So this shows many countries would like to invest in the in this region, not over here. But now it's 2013, you know, is it still relevant? Which has changed already? Where is China? China is here. So is it as improved over here or moved up here? Has improved, China has improved. Any other country have changed? Iraq, yes, Iraq. Iraq is here. Moved where? Cannot move any further. There? Moved over here. Why you say so? Maybe, but I think still it's a risk to go to Iraq to do business. It's still a risk, China has moved. India maybe has improved further. Indonesia has improved further. Okay, new countries also joined here. For example, like North Korea. North Korea would have joined here. Very high end over here. High risk to do business with North Korea. Why North Korea high risk to do business? What is the new development in North Korea? North Korea. What is the new development in North Korea? You never read paper, never listen to news. What is the new development in North Korea? They test nuclear. What's the problem with nuclear? We can use the energy for electricity, right? Why cannot test? US also test what? US test, UK also testing, Japan also testing. They're using for energy. So why North Korea cannot test nuclear? Huh? Yeah, you have the answer, yes. What he's trying to say is, they are a bit protective in nature and they're not transparent as other country. So they may misuse the nuclear energy for war. So that's why people fear to go to North Korea to invest. And they're also not so friendly to other countries as well, compared to US and UK. A political system, a set of formal institutions, all these are the definition of a political system. There are three major types of political system: totalitarianism, socialism, and democracy. In short, I call this TSD. Let me rub this, huh? TSD. Total social, then demo. TSD, yeah? What are the three differences of the political system? Let's look at it. I'll come to this legal system later. Let's finish the political system. I'll come to this later as well. It's a summary of the whole thing. All right. Totalitarianism. Government control all economic and political matters. Total means a total control. By government of the economics and the political matters, E and P matters. They control everything, like North Korea, they control everything of the political and the economic system. A state party is led by a dictator, like North Korea. Membership is mandatory for those wanting to advance. Power is sustained via secret police, propaganda, and regulation of free discussion and criticism. Okay, some countries in the Middle East and Africa, Cuba, North Korea, are the countries that applies the totalitarianism. Former countries are, for example, like China, Germany, Soviet Union, and Spain are the former countries of this practice. For example, China have stopped in 1980s, Germany has stopped in 1945, Soviet Union, Spain. Now the country that practices totalitarianism is some countries in Middle East, such as Syria, and Africa, Cuba and North Korea. Africa, for example, like Tanzania. Okay, Zimbabwe, socialism. So that means in the totalitarianism, total control by the government, a dictatorship. Dictatorship. Let me explain the TSD altogether, then we'll do some comparison. And I'll ask you which country you want to go to invest. Socialism, capital is vested in the state. That means the state own all the capital, not the individual. Please write somewhere there. In socialism, the capital owned by the state. In socialism, the capital owned by state. In democracy, capital owned by individual. We call this state-owned enterprise. Since all the capital owned by the state, we call that all the establishment of business we call state-owned enterprise. Group welfare outweigh individual welfare. This more or less like communism, communism, where the country focus on the group welfare, not on the individual welfare. Government role is to control the basic means of production, distribution and commercial activity. They control all the business activity through state-owned enterprise. Socialism, some of the countries are practicing it. For example, Western Europe, Brazil and India, a mixture of it actually. So government intervention in the private sector, government will intervene in all the private sector business. Corporate income tax rates are very, very high. Democracy. Okay, democracy is better than here and over here, because there is a freedom of choice. The individual are free to invest. Individual free to invest. Own business properties, free to invest in any country. Okay, over here you can't, all owned by the state. Government will intervene in the private investment. Over here there is no intervention. Individual can own business, they can invest in any country, they can start any business. Entrepreneurs are free to do anything. That is we call democracy. So we will do some comparisons here. Okay. Elements in the totalitarianism found in Cuba, North Korea, Libya for example, Sudan, Zimbabwe, socialism, Bolivia, China, Egypt, India, Romania, Russia, Venezuela. Democracy, as you all know, most part of the world, Australia, Canada, Japan, New Zealand, US, most European countries, Argentina, Latin America, Malaysia, Singapore, Brunei, okay, all these are democratic countries. In terms of entrepreneurship, entrepreneurship. As an entrepreneur of international business, where do you want to invest? Here, here, or here? You want to invest here? Here? Maybe, Here? So here we have full freedom. Over here maybe 50-50, but there is a government intervention. over here, all decided by government. All decided by government. So now you would know as an entrepreneur where you want to build your international business, in which country. So this political system is very, very important for entrepreneur to decide whether they want to invest in this country, whether what are the benefits of investing in this type of country, and what are the full freedom they can enjoy by investing in this country. Okay, entrepreneurship means over here, we can divide into few: invest, export, or join venture, franchise. Okay, I want to ask you a question. Can you eat McDonald's burger here? Are you sure or not? Huh? Let's Google whether you can find any McDonald's here or not. Here? Government will have some intervention in the your franchise business. Over here? Full freedom. Of course you can. You can find. Over here? Yes, you may find. Here? You may not find. Okay? Here, of course you can find. Here, may find. Over here, may not find. Okay, these are some of the differences in terms of entrepreneurship decisions, in terms of investing, export, or to collaborate, joint venture and franchise. Okay? Here shows economic freedom and political freedom. Okay? So, here shows not free in terms of political, over here not free in terms of economic. When you go up, that means you're getting freer in terms of economics and politics. And this is what bird here? As an entrepreneur, how far he can fly or she can fly? Over here, for example, many countries are here, for example, like Iran, Syria, as one you mentioned just now. Libya, China, they are moving. Vietnam also moving from socialism, they are moving to democracy. They are moving away. This was 2009, as you mentioned. So now 2013, they have moved, especially like China and Vietnam. The rest maybe not. And we go up. Russia, Pakistan is still here, I think so. Indonesia moving up. Political freedom are not so for Singapore, 2009, but now the political freedom in Singapore is higher compared to now. I think they have moved up over here. There's a change in the political system as well in Singapore. And Philippines, Brazil, Turkey, as I mentioned to you in the yesterday class, Hyundai has invested in Turkey, right? They have moved up. And Japan is here, South Korea, Samsung, Hyundai is from here. Then of course other developed countries such as USA, Sweden, New Zealand, Chile and Germany is all here. So what conclusion you can make from this chart? What conclusion you can make? The higher the freedom, the higher the economic success. The higher the freedom in terms of politics, in terms of economic system, the higher the economic success. The freedom here refers to politics and economy. Where is Malaysia? Malaysia is somewhere in terms of freedom, I think we are very free. In terms of political freedom, maybe we are not there yet. Maybe we are at the region of 5, it's somewhere here. In this cluster. In this cluster here. We have not moved to this cluster. Similar to Japan, South Korea, we have not moved to that level yet. Maybe we are here. We are here. I think earlier we were here and we're moving up. And sometime we will achieve the full freedom. Okay? Democracy, you know. So what do you learn from the democracy? As the slide mentioned here, here full freedom for you to invest. You have full freedom to export. And the third one is to do collaboration. That's what this slide explained to you, how the democracy and openness in the democratic political system helps a company to invest, to export, to collaborate, to franchise, to have licensing, to have a merging acquisition freely based on company strength itself. There is no barrier from the government, which will lead to free, which will lead to free trade. Which will lead to free trade. Okay? So political system is one of the important determinant to achieve a full free trade, full freedom. Okay, political and economic system is closely related. In this slide, we're going to explain to you how the political and economic system closely related. Example, in the totalitarianism, it's associated with command economy. Command, only it's command. You do there, you do this, invest here. Please invest in this business. The company will, the government will tell the company, hey, please invest here. I have no freedom to invest anywhere which I like. Please invest here, which we call command economy. All is commanded, instructed to do things. Democracy, we call it market economy. All fully driven by market demand and supply. This computer business is growing, I will invest here. Because there is a high demand for me. Education is a good investment, I will invest in education. Because high demand, we call this market-driven economy. Whereas in socialism is a mixed economy. There is always a mix in terms of command and market. So the conclusion that we can make is, in the totalitarianism, there is a command economy. In the socialism, mixed. That means command and market. In the democracy-based political system, the economy will be a market economy. In the totalitarianism, it's a command. All is instructed. For example, North Korea, they invest in nuclear. Is it because of a high demand for nuclear? No, it's a government determined. In Iran, government imposed to do investment R&D in nuclear. Is it because of high demand? No, it's not because of demand. In social, it's a mix between C and M. For example, like in Sweden. In Sweden, it is a mixed economy. There is a command, yes, and also there is a market base, Sweden. In democracy, it is purely market driven, purely demand and supply. So these are the relationship between a political system and economic system in a country. It's a closely related. What is a major determinant here? The major determinant is over here is the government. Over here, government fully involved. Over here is there is a balance. Over here, fully private enterprise. Over here is the full government. Over here is a balance between the government and the private sector, G and the private sector. Over here is a private sector. That's a determinants. That shows the government play a very important role in determining the economy. Full government, balance between government and private sector, over here is a private sector. Okay, democracy, socialism. So this is some of the conclusion that we can make from this slide. Once you hear this, you will know, run in your mind. Legal system. Okay, I want to ask one question to see how is the legal system in our country. You are from which country?
Belgium.
Belgium. When you want to enter Malaysia, do you feel ease or difficult to come to our country from the visa application until you present yourself? I mean, until you enter the hotel in Malaysia. How is the legal system in Malaysia?
Very easy.
Yeah.
The university is doing the visa.
University is doing the visa, like USM doing the visa for you.
Yeah, and we have 3 months.
3 months.
So we can be without visa.
You can have a without visa for 3 months.
Yeah. No visa, just go to the country. And so I have to prepare nothing.
3 months is for the what? Processing or no visa?
Without visa.
Without visa. In here, 3 months.
Yeah.
Very good, isn't it? And how is the immigration, for example, when you enter the country, customs and so on? Do they really check you? Or because if you go to US, you have to open your belt. You have to open your shoe. What else open? Your jacket. Yes. Whatever they suspect, you have to open. Especially people like me, where if I have a beard, I got a beard, isn't it? If I go to US, they will suspect me already. They will bring me to a room and check me thoroughly. So that's what, when I go to US, I will shave my beard, even my moustache. Because they always think people with beard and moustache are very dangerous, which is not true. But these US people always think that way. Legal system. If this happens to you as an individual, how about investor? More thorough investigation for an investor. So that is why the legal, as I asked him just now from Belgium, how is to come to our country? If an individual can come so easily to our country, how about products? Can also travel easily, right? How about services? Can also travel easily as an individual? So that's why the legal system is very important for mobility. We call mobility. Mobility. Mobility of what? Individual products and services. He as an individual can enter this country so easily with valid documents. Remember, products can enter this country easily with valid document. Services can enter this country or any other country easily with valid document. If can enter a country without valid document, we call that what? Also very easy to enter, we call that what? Illegal, or trafficking or smuggling. If the smuggling can come easily, also no good. If he can come easily to this country with valid document, okay. If he can come easily to this country without valid document, is it good? No good. We don't want that to happen also. So mobility is determined by the legal system, individual products and services. That is the introduction of this topic. Existence of legal system where rules are clear, isn't it? 3 months free visa. You go to US, once you apply for visa, how long you can stay in the country? You can stay there for 3 to 6 months, but the visa can last for how long? 10 years. The visa you apply here lasts how long? Maybe 6 months, yeah. After that, you have to reapply again, isn't it?
Yeah, you can just make tourist visa.
You have to reapply and get your tourist visa and come back to Malaysia. In US, once you apply, it can last for 10 years. So this is what we call clear. Publicly disclosed, everyone knows, fairly enforced, not close one eye for someone, everyone have the same rule of law, widely respected by individual, organization and the government. Okay, the rule of law is very popular, very common in the advanced economy, but are we saying that in the emerging economy not so advanced? Also advanced, but as I mentioned to you earlier, advanced economy are the one that you saw just now on the high cluster. The emerging economy at the middle. So they are learning and progressing. Advanced economy already learned and they already achieved full political and economic status. So legal system also very perfect. Emerging one in the middle are learning in the progressive way. So legal system is applied to everyone. The important part is here, fairly. Okay? The important part is, it applies to everyone in a fair manner. This is very important. Where are you from?
France.
Okay. Do you have same treatment as from Belgium? He's from Belgium. Do you have same treatment?
Yep.
Yeah. Where are you from?
Belgium.
Sure, same is it? Okay. She is a female. Male. Do you get same treatment as him? In Malaysia? Do you have any differences treatment?
No.
No, So we have a gender equality in Malaysia. Right. Where are you from?
Belgium too.
Belgium too, right. So, he is from France, also received the same fair treatment from the applying until entering the country. So, same goes to over here. Whenever you want to have individual mobility, product mobility, service mobility, we have to apply across the nation. Fair means across the global, not, we provide a special treatment for one from Belgium, another one, no, from Africa, no. Okay. Legal system, we have few laws to look at. First is common law. First is common law. Let me write here. Common law. common. The other one is civil. Then the other one is religious. In common law, things are arbitrary. In civil law, it's already coded. In religious law, it's based on religion. Religion or religious principles. In common law, it's arbitrary. Arbitrary means we have to follow some level of process in providing fair judgment. Okay, that's a different. In civil law, I will go through later. In civil law, all is coded. That means just follow. In religious law also, you have to just follow. Here, we always still can argue. We can still argue. We'll come to this later. So, common law is more freedom. Whenever you can argue, that shows there is a freedom element is already there. Whenever you cannot argue, just follow, there is no freedom. Okay, let's look at it. Common law. So, common law is a legal system that originated from England and spread all over the world, especially Australia, Canada and US. And other members of British Commonwealth like Malaysia follow common law. The basis of law is tradition, past practices, past decision, past remedies, past decision in court and past rulings. Judges have much power to interpret laws based on their circumstances and the individual basis. That is common law. That means I bring up a case, we can argue in the court based on our own interpretation of the law, circumstances, past ruling. That is common law. Civil law? No, just follow. Example, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, Turkey and much of Latin America, based on all inclusive system of law that have been codified, clearly written by legislative bodies. Laws are more cast in stone than common law and not strongly subject to interpretation by courts. A key difference is that common law is mainly judicial in origin and based on court decisions, whereas civil law is mainly legislative and based on laws passed by national and state legislatures. Let's ask our friend here from France, how is the civil law works? How? How? Is it true what they write here? Yes. It's true, huh? Yes. We have to just follow and not much argument in the court. Common law? Can argue. Example, what is our attire in the university? What we should wear? What we shouldn't wear? 20 years ago, I am as a student in a university of Malaya, I can wear a round neck t-shirt with one hole or two holes here. Then pants, we call it Bermuda shorts that time. Then we can even wear a slipper, can come to lecture hall, can go to library, can even go to exam hall. Why? We call it freedom. Still can bring for argument. Yeah, the university says this is our attire, but the student can argue back, saying that this is our university, this is a university that talks about freedom, let's have freedom in our attire. The student can talk back, more towards common law. In civil law, no such thing. I'm giving some examples. In civil law, for example, like University of Uttara, Malaysia, all must wear long sleeve. Even when there is a hot sun, then must wear tie, then black shoe. Even the weather is 38 degrees Celsius, 40 degrees Celsius, you still must wear the. So this is a rule of law. We can call it civil law like in University of Utara Malaysia. University of Utara Malaysia is another university in the northern. How about USM? We must ask the student representative. So how about USM in terms of attire? For me, if you ask me, as long as we are polite in our dressing, no problem. Isn't it? As long as we are polite in our dressing, I think in USM, the way I observe our rules in here, as long as we are polite in our dressing, I think it's allowed. So we are common law again. We still can argue, right? Unlike University of Utara Malaysia, they can argue. That is civil law. Civil law. Okay? Cast in stone already. No argument, please. And the lecturer even can ask the student to go out if you don't follow the certain procedures, example. So that is the difference between common law and the civil law. Just follow. No argument. Here are some of the differences between common law and the civil law for an entrepreneur. Example, ownership of intellectual property. Over here, determined by registration. Over here, determined by prior use. How the company, how the country have used it in the previous case, in the past ruling. Maybe you can refer back to some of the rulings in other country as well. Other country that follow common law can. Enforcing agreements. Enforceable only if it is registered. But over here, proof of agreement is sufficient to enforce. Specificity of contract, it has to be mentioned in the clearly. Over here is, we have to spell out. Usually more costly to draft a contract over here. So contracts can be very detailed with all possible contingencies and spell out. And over here, contracts are very brief and mostly they already filter those issues earlier because they know this is a very important and nobody can argue. They have done all their filtering process before they can do the contract. Over here, we still can argue and change the clauses later. And compliance over here, non-compliance extended to include unforeseeable human acts and so on. Over here is, unless other than the natural disaster, it has to be enforced. So still we can argue over here on the non-compliance. Argue, got freedom over here. Because the clauses are sometimes can be debatable. So we can still argue. Whereas civil law cannot, all must be followed 100%. If not, there will be a strike, there will be a offense and so on. Religious law. Religious law. So this is influenced by the religious, ethical code, moral value and so on. For example, if I steal something from him, in the religious law, sometimes in the, we have a religious law in Kelantan, for example, I haven't implemented yet. If I steal, what happened? Who's from Kelantan here? Nobody want to admit, from Kelantan, but we don't have implemented the hudud law, isn't it? No. Hudud law says, hudud law is another law in Malaysia, but we have not really implemented yet. But the law says, if I steal something, what happened? Cut what? The finger? Or the wrist? Or the arm? Or the hand? If I steal something, depends on the value of the maybe the product that I'm stealing, maybe a finger if it is a chocolate. If it is maybe a expensive watch, maybe a wrist. If I steal a car, maybe a arm. If I steal someone else's wife, maybe a hand. Is it or not? So follow the code of ethics of the particular religion. So this is more strict because it's based on beliefs. based on code of ethics of a particular religion. Legal system also can follow the MIC system. For example, two or more legal systems operating together can. The contrast between civil and common law has become blurred. Yeah, you know. Now the contrast becomes very blurred and very difficult to draw a line. As countries combine both systems, totalitarianism is most associated with religious law and socialist law. Whereas democracy is associated with common law, civil law and the mixed system. For example, legal system in Lebanon, Morocco and Tunisia share elements of civil law and the Islamic law. In Malaysia, we follow common law and some part of the civil law. In these countries, they have civil law and the Islamic law. In Turkey, we follow civil, maybe they have a combination of civil and Islamic law, not the common law. In Malaysia, we have the civil and the common law. If, for example, like this, another political party rule our country, choose the different law, it can change. That means, what is important here? Whether I want to follow this, this or this, who determine? Government. For the political system, who determine? Government. Private organization. For the legal system, who determine? Government. So government play a very important role even in the legal system adoption. Okay, so common law, these are the countries adopting it. In the civil law, these are the countries are adopting it. And the religious law, for example, like Sudan, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan and Afghanistan, Kazakhstan, all these are religious law. And the mixed system, over here, Malaysia, Philippines, Israel, Indonesia, India, Bangladesh. So these actors in political and legal system, I think I already mentioned to you many times about the government. We already covered this in the, I think, little bit in the previous class, but we will look at it again when we talk about trading blocks, WTO. And we also cover this later when we talk about the trading blocks. I'm not covered today. We'll cover about these special interest groups, also very important in the legal system. Over here, labor union are very important also in the legal system. For example, like here, US United Steelworkers have opposed import of steel from China. You see or not? Not the government, not even the legal system. It's the union is the one impacting your international business activities. For example, like in US. Competing business, for example, a Japanese rice producer opposed imports of rice from United States. Customers, motorists in Australia accuse BP of unfair pricing of petroleum products. You see or not? Consumer groups are also very strong. We call these special interest groups. Conservationists, what do they do? For example, environmentalists oppose lumber imports from countries with tropical rainforests. So, because they love green, for example, they say oppose. So look like a lot of special interest groups also play important role in international business. For example, labor union, competing businesses, customers, and the conservationists that talks about the green environment. That's why I asked you to do an assignment on green. Because organizations that do not respect green environment, they can be opposed by these people. Then you cannot enter certain countries such as European Union. They have a strict regulation. if you don't fulfill their requirements on the green product, you cannot enter European Union countries to sell your product. That's why it's very important to look at these special interest groups. In USM, who is a special interest group? Student Council, isn't it? No. In Bahasa Indonesia, we call Majlis Perwakilan Pelajar. They are very important to determine the freedom of student, what to wear, what not to wear, and so on, isn't it? No. Last time in MU, we are very strong. We determine what time you want to go to the class must go on time. That means what time we can go out from the university, what time can come in. Last time in MU, we can go 24 hours in, out. How about USM?
24 hours.
How about you? They have to check you, isn't it? So these are some of the regulations that are set by the students. Special interest group, very important. Country risk produced by political system and government takeover and corporate assets. As I mentioned to you earlier, there are risks involved in the political and the, because of the political and legal system. Let's look at it one by one. We go through quickly. We have another less than 9 slides only. We're going to go through now all the impacts now. So just now, let me recap. We learn about the politics and the legal. Now we're going to look at the effects of the political and legal system. So another 9 more slides, we look at all the effects. Confiscation. Example here in Venezuela. Excuse me. President Hugo Chavez, who just passed away last week, confiscated an oil field owned by French petroleum firm Total. In 2006, Bolivian government nationalized the oil and gas industry. So what happened to the Total? They lose. Will they re-enter again Venezuela? They may tell other friends not to go as well, other businessmen not to go as well. In over here, they nationalized the oil and gas industry. What does it mean? State-owned enterprise. How about the previous assets owned by the private investment? All loss. Okay? We call this expropriation. Asset seizure with compensation. Sometimes even without compensation. Nationalization, takeover by the government through state-owned enterprise. If pay compensation, it's okay. Without paying compensation, it is an effect. So, these are some of the effects of the political system. Bolivia is not so popular in the global business. Venezuela also not so popular in the global business because of the political system. These are some of the examples of just now on the Venezuela government on expropriation. That means they take the asset without paying compensation. Sanctions. Embargo. For example, now US put sanction on what country? What country is that in the Middle East? US put sanction on what country now? Iran. Why they put sanction on Iran? Because Iran does unregulated nuclear tests. So they put a lot of sanction. These are government political system that affects the business. Embargo. Embargo is a ban of export and import that forbid everything of business activity. For example, the US has enforced embargo against Iran and North Korea, labeled as state sponsors of terrorism. Boycott. All these are some of the effects because of the political system. Boycott is a voluntary refusal of to engage in commercial dealings with a nation or company. Boycott. Just boycott them. Citizens boycotted Disneyland Paris. From France. True or not? Let me know. To express opposition to globalization and takeover of French farmland. They boycott. So they build the Disneyland, the farmland. Is it true? Huh? It's a farmland. They build the Disneyland. So they boycotted. French farmers boycotted McDonald's and crashed a tractor into the shop to vent their anger with agricultural policies and globalization. Why? Because they don't want them to come into their country. Boycott. But now everyone is accepting the McDonald's. Why? Earlier they were here in terms of political and economic freedom, but now they are moving out. They are getting more free. When they get more free, they welcome all these investors. Come to my country, invest. I'll eat your burger. In this class, who never eat burger? Everyone eat burger, isn't it? Because you attain the political freedom and economic freedom to welcome them to our country. Are it or not? War, terrorism, all is going to impact the business of international. So this is going to be the impact of the risk produced by the political system. Will you go to a country that got war or not? Never, isn't it? I don't think so, you go. So, these are some of the effects of the political system of the particular country. Now we look at the country risk arising from the host country legal environment. Host country means? Nestle from Sweden. So, it's a home country for Nestle. Now, Nestle invests in Malaysia. It's a host country for Nestle. That is a definition of home and host. So, let's look at the host country legal environment over here. Let's say in Malaysia, foreign investment law, we're going to look at it one by one. Let's look at it over here. This is a home country. We're going to look at it one by one. Let's look at the host country. Foreign investment law affect the FDI based entry. For example, like Japan, the large scale retail store law restricted foreigners from opening Toys R Us. Wow, you see not? How the host country law, like Japan, restrict Toys R Us? Why? Because they can kill all the small retailers. In Malaysia, we are very good. We can, anyone can come and invest. We don't worry about the small retailers. Yes. In Japan, they worry. That's why I say that Malaysia is getting from the middle towards the top, you know, giving the full freedom for investor. In Japan, no. You see, they say no to Toys R Us. They say no to Texco. They say no to Carrefour. Why? They can kill the small retailers. These are some of the laws in the host country. Control on operating firms, for example, in the telecommunication sector, China, for example, Chinese government require foreign investor to seek joint venture with local firm. If you go to Cambodia, Cambodia government will say joint venture. Cannot do free lance investment. Always must do joint venture with the Cambodians. This is some of the control in the country, host country. Marketing and distribution laws in the host country. Example, Finland, France, Norway and New Zealand prohibit cigarette advertising on television. True? Oh, see? Marketing in France cannot advertise cigarette. In Malaysia can? 20 years ago can. Last 10 years cannot. Okay? Canada and other countries kept prices in the pharmaceutical and other industries. See or not? A lot of marketing, distribution, control. Laws and income repatriation, environmental law and contract laws For example, in Germany, firms are responsible for recycling product packaging, as I mentioned to you about Coca-Cola. Inadequate or underdeveloped legal system to protect the investor. For example, in China, Russia, foreign firms sometimes abandon business venture due to erratic legal environment. Too bad for them to do business. Extraterritoriality and foreign corrupt practices are too severe in the country. Now we go to the home country. How is the physical asset valuation? For example, Canada and the US use historical costs. Some Latin American countries use inflation adjusted market value. You see or not? In the home country, there are differences in terms of physical asset valuation. R&D costs also very different. Example, expense has incurred in most of the world. Expense are capitalized in South Korea and Spain. Some countries use both conventions. So R&D is an expense in the most part of the world. Example, like in Malaysia, R&D normally we consider as expense. But in South Korea and Spain, as a capital. So difference in terms of accounting. Transparency in financial reporting also very different, countries to countries. So in the legal system, we have common law, civil law, religious law, and the government is very important to determine what law to use. And we have different set of laws to attract investors in the host country. And there are some differences in terms of accounting, transparency in the home country. Okay, so this slide summarizes what we learned today. Political system, legal system. It's very important, determined by the government, legislative bodies, lobbying groups, special interest groups, trade union and others. And over here is very important in terms of order, in ensure order in the commercial activities, resolve disputes, what law to use, protect intellectual property, tax economic output. Okay, this is how we are going to summarize today's topic.